Hey, happy Friday, everybody. Mark again here at Weatherman Plus. Now, we have some sneaky waves that's going to come through, and we're going to start going towards an active pattern after we get away from all this dry air and dust in about a week. So I'm going to show you the latest information so you know what is going on in the tropics. And I will give you updates as well. If you've never been here before, make sure you subscribe. I am all year along with my weather forecasting and other hurricanes like Ian and such. I usually give weeks in advance so people can try and stay alert and get prepared the best way they can. Make sure you subscribe. That way you are ahead of the tropics. Thank you all so much for all the likes and shares yesterday. That did help a lot of people know about the heat that's coming through and how long it's going to last with the correct information, as well as what's going on with the severe weather risk that is growing. Thank you all so much for caring. Now let's get into your latest update. Remember, all timestamps are in the description below. Now before I go into it, Texas, you're still in my thoughts. Right now, y'all are sitting still at 1 million homes without power. And if you have two or three people per home, you're talking 2-3 million people. So there's a lot of people still without power. Now you can see from National Hurricane Center, in 72 hours, we're still going to have this nice big high pressure that's going to be rolling through the Atlantic and stretching through the Gulf of Mexico. Now this is going to start retracting back in about a week. And what we need to watch out for is potential storms, tropical waves, that rides in that direction. It could either turn and go into the Gulf after that or go around the southeast, maybe even east coast of the United States, of the lower 48. Showing on our latest potential velocity anomaly that we do have systems that's going to be forming into the eastern Pacific. That is still going to be a thing. That is not going away. But we also have something that could form up right into our Caribbean and maybe the east coast of the United States. A strong anomaly, a lot of lift, a lot of favorable environment for storms to grow. And you can see all the unfavorable environment all around it from the high pressure expanding and retracting back. Now you can see the same thing from the Euro. You can see we have storms going into the eastern Pacific as well as we go through the coming days. But right around the late teens, potentially into the early 20s, Euro takes it just a few days later, that we do have something coming right in that very same area, a little bit weaker than what we're seeing with GFS. But then again, if you see this right here, that formed barrel. So a little bit of help, a little bit of enhancement of this tropical wave, and it could potentially be a worst case scenario. I will keep my eyes on it. And you can also see from the latest from the MJO that as we go towards the high teens of July, we're going to start becoming into a neutral to a favorable environment. And as we go into the 20s of July, this is where a lot of lift, a lot of favorable environment is coming into our area. You also see here from the Euro, once you go 7 days, still have those tropical waves going to be pushing through Central America into Eastern Pacific. But then we're going to start getting our chance for these tropical waves to come off to MDR and start stretching towards Turks and Caicos, towards Bahamas, maybe even towards the southeast and going further into the Gulf, maybe going around the southeast of the lower 48. This turn is still not known. Now, instead of the high teens, Euro takes it into the lower 20s, where we start having some tropical waves that starts ramping up with speed. And this is right where your high pressure would be going clockwise, pulling everything into this direction. If it expands out, then your high pressure would be going further around and it would expand this into this direction. Showing on the latest that you don't see any formation yet, and this is usually what we get into July, we get late formations that pop up from a tropical wave that has problems with the high pressure, with the dry air from the dust, and forms late. Showing maybe around the low 20s, something could form up right there into the Gulf of Mexico, and showing that the odds become even better as we go towards the end of July, getting chances for formations, either going around the southeast or going into our Gulf of Mexico. So when you look at the ensembles, you can see right here by the GEFS that you have this big high pressure expanding, but it's stronger in the Atlantic and not all the way into the Gulf. And we have a wave coming through the Leeward Islands, Leeward and Windward Islands. And as that goes by Puerto Rico, it starts strengthening up towards a tropical depression, a tropical storm, and tries to become a hurricane or just a strong tropical storm right off the East Coast as you go into the low 20s. But it forms up into the high teens and just takes a while. It just travels for a long time. And you can see we still have those waves going to the eastern Pacific as well, but this is showing a particular concern against the coast. So I waited for the update to see what the trend is, and the latest update on GEFS is showing that it will still remain weak and maybe get into the Caribbean. Remember, if it's weak, it'll go further to the west. If it's stronger, it'll start turning a little bit. Showing on the update that it remains weak, but still catches that turn a little bit later and still forms up something by the Bahamas, right by the southeast, strengthens up along the coast, weakens back down, and moves away. At the same time, you can see right after that, another potential headed towards the Gulf. So we're starting to go into an active period. Until then, we will see him into the eastern Pacific as well. Well, we could be getting both. Showing with your precipitation that it will start adding up all the way from the Caribbean all the way across the Bahamas and the southeast and the east coast of the U.S. You can see this on a Euro as well, agreeing that the precipitation will start adding up in that area. Now, whether the high pressure is there and chokes it out and it can't do anything with the dust as well, or whether it has a moment to get through, we still got to see for updates. Because the ensemble of the Euro is also seeing this going to eastern Pacific, but also showing right around the low 20s is when we're going to start getting formation. And you can see those sneaky waves forming up at the last minute right into the Gulf of Mexico multiple times, and still possible to go right along the southeast of the coast. So once we go into the high teens, into the early 20s, our tropics are going to wake right back up. And you can see this on the Euro as you're going towards the very early 20s. These waves are going to start coming off weak, but they're going to start trying to breathe at the same time, trying to come in early in the Gulf. And that's normally what we see in July. And this sneaky little tropical wave coming into the Gulf, while these go around the high pressure, then more opportunities popping up in the Gulf. Late waves forming late, and that's normally what we get in July. And you can see this here. Normally in July, more than likely you get waves popping up by the Caribbean, and then it goes around the southeast, the lower 48, or it goes west because it stays weak and forms up late into the Gulf. And as we go into August, this is going to obviously become stronger paths. Those wondering about the temperatures, Beryl didn't affect anything. You still have very warm temperatures in the Caribbean, going by the Bahamas, warmest by the Bahamas, going around the southeast, the lower 48, and into the Gulf of Mexico. We got a little bit below average into the Gulf from Beryl. Still very warm temperatures in there. All you need is 80 to sustain a tropical system. Now, when you take a look at the old Farmer's Almanac long range and see what is getting predicted potentially coming around, and this is a surprisingly very accurate weather forecast that these people do. So remember, this link is in the description below. That way you can go check out for your area for yourself. Showing so far for the Texas, Oklahoma, and this region for the South Central, you still have a chance, potentially according to them, for a tropical storm threat from the 17th through the 19th. And that's kind of the waves that we're seeing now. Also down the road, another potential one as we go through the 19th through the 21st of August. You can also see for the deep south, for Louisiana, Mississippi, and Alabama, that you do have a threat for a tropical storm system sometime around the 25th from the 15th, maybe on the western side, more towards Louisiana, more towards that Texas threat as you go through the 15th through the 25th. So we are going through an active period that a lot of people also see. Showing that it's about to be even more active if we go towards the end of July to beginning of August. So as you look for Florida, you can see as you go towards August, they actually believe that you have a hurricane threat north in Florida from the 25th through the 28th. And I could head right up the coast. You can see for the southeast. So as you go from Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina, you can see as you go towards the August situation that the potential hurricane that could be affecting Florida could go right up the coast and affect y'all as well. Showing it could continually go right up the East Coast, right towards the coast of the Northeast, right by Maryland, Delaware, New Jersey, right towards New England, that you could start having a threat also. If that hurricane forms by Florida in the southeast, it could weaken down and bring you tropical storm conditions shortly after that. I thought this was very interesting because they called mini storms as well. Now, the one difference that the Euro sees that the other ones don't quite see yet, this is why I think maybe it would be a Caribbean going into the Gulf situation, because if it came by this way, the reason why it would stay weak is you have this upper level low, this tut forming, bringing a lot of shear against that wave as you go into the high teens, and then shortly after dissipate. So if it does travel in this direction, it would remain weak because of the shear but it could form up later as it gets pulled around the high pressure or still go into the Gulf. Now, as of now, National Hurricane Center don't have anything for the next 7 days because it literally starts in about 7 days after all this dust passes through. Still showing my severe weather forecast for yesterday is still accurate. Now, we do have storms for tomorrow, and we did have chances for wind and hail as well. The tornado threat is very small for tomorrow. Now, tomorrow is Sabbath, and man shall not live by bread alone. Amen. You do have to get your spiritual food as well and strengthen your spirit. But if I do see lives at risk, if I see this tornado threat getting worse, I will upload a quick severe weather video for tomorrow, but my next upload will be on Sunday morning, if not. So we have a lot of things changing. So we have all this heat building. It is summer after all. We have these storms still coming in for the next few days, and our tropics are going to start changing in about a week. But before I go, Matthew 10, 16 through 22. Behold, I send you forth as sheep in the midst of wolves. Be ye therefore wise as serpents, and harmless as doves. But beware of men, for they will deliver you up to the councils, and they will scourge you in their synagogues. And ye shall be brought before governors and kings for my sake, for the testimony against them and the Gentiles. This is Jesus speaking. But when they deliver you up, take no thought how or what ye shall speak, for it shall be given you in the same hour what ye shall speak. For it is not ye that speak, but the Spirit of your Father which speaketh in you. And the brother shall deliver up the brother to death, and the father the child, and the children shall rise up against their parents, and cause them to be put to death. And ye shall be hated of all men for my name's sake, but he that endureth to the end shall be saved. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I will keep you updated. Remember, all glory does go to God, our Father, Yahweh, in heaven. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life, you and everyone around you, and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a happy Friday, everybody. I wish the best for every single one of y'all.